Now this question 23 is a straightforward question based on torque acting on an electric dipole. It says that an electric dipole is placed at an angle of 30 degree with an electric field intensity is given. It experiences a torque equal to 4 Newton meter, that is given the charge on the dipole if the dipole length is there. So you see torque is equal to, you happen to use the expression P cross E, that is P sine theta. So I will be using the expression torque is equal to charge into length L. This is the dipole moment into electric field into sine theta. Now you are supposed to calculate the value of Q. Q is torque upon L E sine theta. You substitute the values. You understand? What are the values? Torque has been given equal to 4 Newton meter. Length has been given 2 centimeter. So you convert into meter, 2 into 10 power minus 2. Electric field intensity is 2 into 10 power 5. And sine 30. So what is sine 30? Sine 30 is 1 by 2. So ultimately you will be getting 2 millicoulomb, you understand, 2 millicoulomb will be the value of charge. So 2 millicoulomb is the second option. So answer will be option number 2 for question number 23. Now let us switch over to question 24. Now this question 24, which is based on capacitance, it reads that a parallel plate capacitor of area A, as you can see in the diagram, like the total area is A and it is filled with four types of dielectric. It says that parallel plate capacitor of area A, plate separation D has been given to you, and capacitance C is filled with four dielectric materials, as you can see here, K1, K2, K3 and K4. K4 is covering the entire lower portion, but K1, K2, K3, they are the three equal parts covering the upper half, right? So with four dielectric materials having dielectric constants K1, K2, K3 and K4 as shown in the figure below. Now they are asking if a single dielectric material is to be used, like you have to find out the equivalent dielectric constant of all the four dielectric materials. So have the same capacitance C in this capacitor, then its dielectric constant K is given by, and the options are as follows. Now see, if you assume that it was an air capacitor and its capacitance is say C dash, right? Then what you have to understand here is that this lower dielectric material is to be divided into three parts, and then these two together in series, then these two together in series, and these two together in series, and finally you have to connect all three of them in parallel. So if you go by that approach, you will not be getting any option which is given here. So what we are thinking here is that the upper three dielectric materials, they have to be treated in parallel, and together they have to be treated in series with the lower material. Understand? So what we are doing here is, let us suppose the total air capacitance was C dash. So here this portion will be having the capacitance 2 C dash, and this one will be having 2 C dash by 3, 2 C dash by 3 and 2 C dash by 3. Right? Now these three capacitors will be treated in parallel, and together they will be treated in series with this. So if you do that, you will be writing 1 by K equivalent, which you have to calculate, into C dash. This will be 1 upon K4 2 C dash plus 1 upon together these three in parallel. So this is K1 plus K2 plus K3 into 2 C dash upon 3. Now both the sides C dash will be cancelled out, and you can calculate the expression relating K with K1, K2, K3 and K4. If you do that, you will be finding option 3, correct option for this available situation. So we are marking answer 3 for this question, which is the most appropriate answer for this particular situation. Now let us switch over to question 25. Now this question 25 is very basic question in which Ohm's law can be used. You are supposed to calculate the potential difference between point A and B. It says that potential difference VA minus VB between the points A and B in the given figure is. So here the convention is that if current is flowing in this direction, so you can take it as higher potential, lower potential. Cell potential higher, lower is already given to you. And here also if the current is flowing in this direction, so this is at higher potential and this is at lower potential. So if you start writing down the equation starting from point A, so you will be writing as VA minus I into R, that is minus 4 volt, then you are jumping here across, that is minus 3 volt, and then here minus 2 volt, and you will be reaching point B. So VA minus VB, this will be simply 9 volt. So which option is 9 volt? This is fourth option is 9 volt. So I will be marking answer 4 for this question 25. So let us switch over now to question 26.